Hey everybody, it's Jeff, Aromatics, working on my cigar journal once again, where I smoke a cigar, usually for the first time, and record it in a video format so I can share it with you guys. Today I will be reviewing a cigar I've been waiting for quite a while to smoke because it's quite unique. It is the Volute by the LCA, Privada Club. What's special about this one is it's all Peruvian tobacco. It actually has quite a cool story, a backstory to it. And I'll leave a link in the bucket below to the video. And it's sort of like a little mini documentary of how this cigar came to be. And it's interesting for sure. And I recommend that if you're into that kind of stuff, to definitely check it out. So this is, like I said, a 100% Peruvian cigar, the filler, the binder, and the wrapper. So that makes me quite curious to see what, you know, how they could blend that from one tobacco. Not only that, it's one particular seed, and that is the pelo de oro, which means golden hair, because I think that's what it looks like when it's cured in the barn. It kind of looks like golden hair. So it's just got a nice nice light brown, almost like a darker Connecticut type of wrapper on there, although it is Peruvian. I think it actually looks pretty good, considering that Peru isn't known for a wrapper leaf, so the fact that they could actually come up with some leaves that would be good enough to wrap a cigar this size, which looks like it's about a 48 by 6.5, I'm guessing. And the smell I'm getting is a really nice sweet hay. Draws really good. Not getting anything particularly interesting that stands out there. So okay, I got a hearth to go to, so I'm gonna smoke this while I'm at the hearth, pay some attention to the flavors, and I'll be back in a little bit and let you know what I'm getting. So stick around. Okay, I'm back. This one's gonna be a little bit trickier than usual to describe. So first of all, the construction and the performance has been really good. I've had to touch it up a little bit, but it's one of those cigars that it's easy to touch up. You just put a little bit of flame and it evens right out. So the burn is fine. The flavors I'm getting, first of all, I guess the basics would be it's probably a light cigar, but with medium flavor. There's lots of flavors going on and they're kind of unique. I would say generally it's a sweeter type of cigar. Sweeter flavors, yep. But it's what makes this stand out is those little nuances that are coming out. So the first thing I got was just an interesting kind of a sweet cinnamon spice, maybe a little bit of a nutmeggy type of thing going on there, but it's really light and it's on the sweet side. Another really interesting characteristic is it seems to give a little bit of heat in the back of your throat, very little. Like sort of the best thing I can maybe describe is if you've ever ate cooked cabbage, or not cooked cabbage, but raw cabbage, and sometimes you get like a lingering heat, and this is like that, it stays there. But it's definitely not a spicy cigar, it's not a pepper bomb or even really much pepper at all. Except for on the retrohale, there's a nice mild burn with maybe a little bit of white pepper. Quite interesting. So yeah, like I said, so far a light-ish cigar, but with lots of interesting flavors. So stick around and I'll be back to tell you more. All right, let's finish up this review. Very interesting cigar. The flavors I would describe as it came to my mind is licorice, like a natural licorice taste. If you've ever had natural licorice, it looks like a root. It's a type of a root. Look, and I used to chew on them like a toothpick and get that slight sweet saccharine sweetness. It's got that if you've ever tasted like licorice or anise, but a very mild version of that. That's kind of the basic flavor with a type of woodiness. I'm still getting that spice in the back of my cheeks that just lingers there, like not spice, but a heat. On the retrohale, it's got some nice bite to it, but it's not a bite that burns your nose, if that makes any sense. It's substantial without burning. And that in there, you're getting a little bit of white pepper and some cinnamon, and also that heat that you're getting in the back of your mouth is kind of a cinnamony taste too. The aroma I'm getting is kind of a floral sweet honey. Very, very unique. This is a great example of to show that you can actually make a really tasty and good cigar from just one type of tobacco. Not only is it from Peru, but it's all, as far as I know, Palo de Oro seed. So okay, I'm gonna leave it at that. Hope you guys enjoyed my review, and I'll see you guys in my next one. So till then, Aromatics, signing out.